Hi everyone, I'm Katie with FileCloud. I'm joined by Jason Dover, the Chief Product Officer at FileCloud. How are you doing?
Hey, pretty good. Good to see you today, Katie. Happy to be here to chat.
Awesome. So we're going to be talking about FileCloud Desktop today. We're going to be going over just some quick questions and answers. So Jason, could you tell us what is FileCloud Desktop?
Sure. FileCloud Desktop is our new client application, as the name implies, for the desktop experience. So, giving people a new client that they can install on their Windows or Mac machines and leverage this for accessing, collaborating, and syncing with the files that's stored in their FileCloud ecosystem. It's currently in beta, and we started the first phase focusing on macOS. And so that beta is available right now for macOS systems.
Awesome. So, why is this application important and what does it deliver to customers?
Yeah, I'd say there's four core reasons why it's important. The first is that a solution like FileCloud that provides content synchronization and collaboration capabilities, it really should be seamlessly integrated with your desktop experience, right? From an end user perspective, you shouldn't even necessarily have to know that you're engaging with FileCloud directly. It should just feel like you're accessing your files, accessing your client, your content, and provide it with an easy way for collaborating with your coworkers and your partners and so forth. So FileCloud Desktops, its primary intention is really to take the experience that we've already delivered historically today and make that even more seamless in terms of how it integrates with the desktop environment. Second point here is that Apple has recently made some changes to how third-party systems and solutions can interact with the file system. This requires some architectural updates for our client applications. This is actually really a good opportunity because the outcome is going to be a solution that's even more integrated into the Mac environment. A third point would be simplification, right? FileCloud today offers a variety of applications, a variety of services that allows for FileCloud to be an extension of your desktop environment, to be an extension of your Microsoft Office ecosystem. These requires different add-ins and different services to run, but they're all somewhat loosely coupled and independently managed, right? FileCloud Desktop is meant to unify that. So as an example, we have clients that allow you to lock Office files, right? We have clients that allows you to start your experience with an Office document online and then transition that to your local, let's say Microsoft Word or Microsoft PowerPoint. All of those capabilities we're looking to manage and frame them inside of the FileCloud Desktop envelope so that customers have less that they have to worry about when they're using these different services. A fourth point, and I would say this is more kind of long-term thinking, but it's just the vision that we have around how the user experience will evolve over time. So over the next 12 to 18 months, things like real-time collaboration, more control and more granularity when it comes to notifications, understanding what's going on with the content in your ecosystem that you care about. FileCloud Desktop will pave the way for us to make a number of improvements across those fronts as well.
That sounds really exciting and like it'll deliver a
Yes.
lot of value. So, with that being said, thinking about the customers, who should leverage FileCloud Desktop? Who is this built for?
Yeah, that's a good question. As noted, the first phase of the beta is on Mac OS, and we're working on extending that for the Windows environment as well. Late 2023, early 2024 is when we're expecting that. So the starting point are folks that have Macs, right? That's the kind of starting point. But it's really relevant for any customers that engage with their content that's in FileCloud via desktop clients, as opposed to exclusively leveraging web and mobile. So if you are trying to deliver that experience for your customers where they can access their files locally on their machines, like local drives, without needing to go to a web client, then you're certainly within the envelope of being a candidate for starting to try the beta out.
Awesome. So how can users gain access to FileCloud Desktop?
Yeah, the good thing is that it doesn't require a dedicated, isolated environment the way that some betas do. This can be deployed right in your current production system that you have in your infrastructure, and you can get perhaps task groups to start evaluating it. And we'd love to get feedback on what that experience is like today. The only dependency is that the FileCloud server needs to be running at least version 23.1, our latest release. The good thing is that if a customer is using the SaaS version of FileCloud Online, they've already been upgraded by our team. So they're already there. For those with on-premises deployments or hosted deployments, they'll need to make sure that server, the FileCloud server, is updated to 23.1, and then they can deploy the desktop client and it'll just work.
Awesome. So we've gone over a few facets of FileCloud Desktop. We know a bit more about it, but for people who want to look for more information, where can they find it?
They can actually find it right on the FileCloud homepage. There's a banner right along the top that will take them to the dedicated FileCloud Desktop page. On our downloads page on filecloud.com, where all of our clients and add-ins are, there's also a link there to get to FileCloud Desktop, or they can just go to the link displayed on the screen right now as well.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much for your time. This was a really great sneak peek into FileCloud Desktop, and we're excited to share this new client application, especially with beta, with our Mac users, and looking forward with our Windows users. So thank you so much for watching, everyone.
Thanks a lot, Katie. Always a pleasure.
All right. Take care.